people who sit next to you, if they look at you weird, you are a flyer. If they move little away from you, you are a frequent flyer. That is the way you get your pass. Whether you are a flyer or a frequent flyer. If they just look at you and continue their pranayama, you are a flyer. If they just move and then continue their pranayama, you are a frequent flyer. So how many of you get the frequent flyer pass? Raise your hand. Okay. Good. Actually, why the levitation happens, you know, your body becomes lighter than your mind. See, your mind is nothing but heaviness. Incompletions are the heaviness. It sits on you like a load, heavy. When your body is able to handle that heaviness, means that heaviness has dissolved. The heaviness of the mind, the heaviness of the incompletion has dissolved. Naturally, your body becomes light and starts moving. Understand? Your kundalini naturally starts vibrating towards the higher states of consciousness. So the body also cooperates with it, moves with it. It will be so much of joy. How many of you experience when your body jumps, it is so much of joy? It is not, see that sound only. It is not just you are jumping, it's so much of joy. Every cell, every bio memory, every muscle memory will jig, 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 jig. Now I can show you various methods, various people jumping. I wanted to ask, how many of you, because you're already working with the team lead for the last few days, see that joy and bliss when you enrich the other person? Raise your hand. How many of you feel it strengthens the parts of you? I'm really telling you, my own enlightenment, when it happened at the age of 12, it did not stay with me. It went away, 2.5 days. Third day evening, it started diminishing. But when I started enriching the world with whatever I got, I saw not only it came back, it just deeply got settled into my whole system, filling my muscle memory, bio memory, and established in my system eternally. I tell you, many times people ask me, can I keep the same joy and excitement which I am having in the inner awakening? What can I do? How many of you have that question? Enriching. Enriching is the answer. When you start enriching, it starts getting rooted and rooted in you and stays in your system eternally. In your whole being, eternally. Listen, when you speak to others listening, when you are enriching, how many of you got new clicks and understandings which you never heard in the class? Can I have some of your sharing? Can you guys queue up to the mic? Listen, I want only to listen to. Suddenly some of the clicks, clarity, understanding, experience opens up when you are enriching, which you have not received in the class. The enriching itself becomes a learning process, growing process. Come to the mic. Go ahead.
Hello, Swamiji. You were talking about talking into your listening and talking into other people's listening. Some people began asking me what does it mean. I myself struggled with that initially until I realized that when you're talking into other people's listening, you're actually understanding their doubts and overcoming them.
How many of you understood this? Raise your hand. please understand, whoever you meet, all their doubts are your unsaid doubts. The moment the doubt comes, if you have answer, you already answered that doubt. If you also get that same doubt, still you have not spoken into your listening. So both the way it is beneficiary for you.
That's it.
Nityanand Swamiji, the co-creating process that we did, I had always heard that helping
Mike.
Helping others would help us, but I never really believed that. But when we did the co-creating process, and when people shared how they could help me to achieve all my goals, I got so many new ideas, which when I sat and thought for myself...
Why asking you to think for others, you know, I'm telling you the truth. Now, when you think for 10 people, the brain, the ability expands. So now with a 15 brain, you can live your life. Understand? That is Vishwarupa. Having 10 heads. Suddenly you see, all your problems look too small. How many of you found that? When you started thinking for others, you are able to simply think for you. It's expansion of the possibilities.
What I saw was there was so much of sincerity in people when they wanted to help me. And when I was giving my suggestions and help, what I could help them, I saw that even I was very sincere in giving my suggestions and help to them, which I was not before outside. Though I knew it would help, I was never for it. And
here it becomes experience.
I always thought how it could be possible. But today, in that process, I realized by helping others... it definitely helps us.
Not only that, you will get out of this idea, too much is in my plate.
Yes.
Understand? How many of you live your whole life with this idea, too much is in my plate, how am I going to finish this? Raise your hand. Too much is in your head, not in the plate. Understand? I always feel I don't have work. No, I'm really telling you. I always feel I don't have work. I feel I am so free. No work. I don't know how you guys will understand. But I really feel, I'm telling you. What is there? No work. Maybe... when you are thinking too much about your inner image, low self-esteem, you feel too much is in your plate. That's all.
Nityanandam Swamiji, actually I just wanted to share an experience where in my last IA, when I think it was one of the first few days when Swamiji asked us, who over here wants freedom and power? Or actually, yeah, so everybody raised their hands except myself and another lady. And I thought it was very odd that people would want power and freedom, but I want enlightenment. And that's why I'm here. And I just didn't realize that not being in a powerful space was stopping my enlightenment. So the most important lesson I learned in my last IA was to always operate from the space of powerfulness. And just because I operated from the space of powerfulness, I was able to bring my children for IA. I did not force them. I was able to speak into their listening from a powerful space. And for this little one, younger one, he's not little, he's 15. for this one,
no, but in India, we call, even if you are 30, you are little one only. And you know, funny thing, you will really be shocked. After I started my public life, I became a public figure, well-known Hindu religious leader. I think in 2009 means I started my public life in 2003. 2009, 6 years, 7 years after my public life, my mother's mother, grandmother, She comes and meets me in the ashram and says, come away to the home. We are all missing you. Why did you leave us and go away? No, really. She is telling in Tamil. என் பேரன் இல்லாத கதை எனக்கு தான் தெரியும், எனக்கு தான் அந்த கவலை, சாமி வீட்டுக்கு வந்துடலாம் இல்ல. When I left the house when I was 17 and wandered, achieved whatever I need to achieve in spiritual realization and everything, and came to the public life. Now I am a public figure with lakhs of disciples and sannyas parampara, the whole thing. Now thousands leave their house to come and live with me, and she is coming and telling me, yen pera illada kore enak thana theriyum yaarukku vena enna vena irukatume. She told in Tamil, anybody can tell you are a god, you are a guru, they can worship you and do puja to you and listen to you. Missing my grandson only I know.